Thinking about our experience, one of those stories that I used to have problems with came to me. And that is the story of a couple of people fleeing Jerusalem after Jesus had been crucified. A couple of his followers decided to get the heck out of town before the rest of them got rounded up and the same thing happened to them. And they were on their way to a place called Emmaus. And as they're walking, someone they didn't recognize comes up to them and decides to travel along with them. And he says, "Why are you guys so sad?" And they're like, "Dude, what rock did you just crawl out from under? You know, have you not been around? You know, our main guy just, you know, got himself nailed to a tree. And then this morning, you know, they went to go take care of his body. He's not there. And their world was kind of upside down, you know." But they continue on their path. and they get to where they're going to rest for the night. And rather than just send this guy on his way, they say, you know, hey, why don't you stay with us? You know, why don't you have dinner with us? And so he does, and in the moment they're sitting down to eat, he takes the bread and he breaks it. And what? And they realize, oh. And in the moment that they know who it is, he vanishes. That's a parable, just like the parables that Jesus told in his life. And what it's really about is that Christ Spirit is always with us. But as I think about us, as I have looked at each of you over the past few days, it's been kind of like that moment in Emmaus where I see, oh, it's you. And I realize you all have been with me for over 3 decades. Every one of you. You know, when I find myself in zeal about a new project that I'm going to do, Stephen, with me. When I am simply finding the good person, the good heart that is simple and pure within myself. I know Carol Sue's with me. When I somehow reach out to someone in compassion, I miss it. And in all those times when I make an audio little play on words in my mind and chuckle, I know Brian. You know, and I could say that about all of you. All of you walked with me. At one point in his ministry, Jesus was surrounded by a crowd, and his mother and biological brother showed up, and some of the folks said, hey, you know, we've let them in here. And they said, you know, Jesus, you know, your mother and your brothers are here. And he says, who is my mother? Who are my brothers? These, you know, you are my family. This is our tribe. These are the people that we came from. And just as those two people walking through Emmaus suddenly realized that they were not alone, that Jesus was with them. As I have looked into your faces this weekend, I have realized I've never, ever been with you. I've always had all of you with me. And damn it, in this moment that I realize that you're going to vanish. But only from this sight, you know, because when I recall, when I really get in touch, when I go within to that place that I used to think was empty, you're there. You're all there. And what I have realized is how much you all need, how much I miss. And I don't ever want to get over this long again without seeing you. Because we've still got a few miles to go before we get to the next. Please join me in prayer. Sweet Spirit, we're so grateful for all the miles that we have walked together, for all the time that we have spent in one another's hearts. Today, as we break bread, as we bless one another with our love, with our hugs and kisses, our words, our goodbyes, we see in each person here small piece of us. We recognize that part of ourselves that we've carried for so long. And for every precious memory, every inspiring example, every tender moment, every smile, every laugh, every tear we share. We are so profoundly grateful. We are never alone, and in the fullness of this time and this moment, we remember. We remember.
God bless you all. Go with God.
Take it easy on the door.